Guys, Ford has nearly 5,000 skilled auto tech jobs that it cannot fill. In fact, they are so desperate to hire these types of skilled laborers that they're offering $120,000 annually. Guys, this is nearly double the US average income. And over the past few years, they've just continuously increased the amount of compensation for these types of jobs. But don't just take my word for it. Listen to what the CEO, Jim Farley, has to say. Quote, "We have over a million openings in critical jobs, emergency services, trucking, factory workers, plumbers, electricians, and tradesmen." Guys, we're always on this channel, almost always, talking about people being fired, people not being able to find jobs. But I think this is a really interesting and compelling story about maybe we just don't have the right types of jobs available. Or maybe us, our kids, their kids are not really looking and adapting to the job market appropriately. And today I just want to briefly kind of cover what's happening in the trades, look at some of the education, one of the problems, and just kind of double click on what Jim Farley is saying here. I think it comes at a particularly interesting time when the H-1B visa program is really raging, the conversation. And I'll be covering that in a lot more detail later this week. So make sure you hit subscribe, like the channel, so you're here when we go deep into what's happening with the H-1B visa program. Because one of the things that Trump said last week is that we don't have enough skilled labor, basically. And it's interesting to me that the Ford CEO says that too. He says, we're 5,000 short, we're closing stuff, we're not able to serve all the plants that we have. So anyway, let's double click on this, let's go a little bit deeper. Because it's not just the auto mechanics, it's US manufacturing in total. And he basically is letting off alarm bells here and saying that US manufacturing is in a potential crisis. There are 400,000 open manufacturing jobs as of August of this year. 400,000. I mean, we've been talking about tens of thousands of jobs and layoffs and these various AI exposed types of professions. But what we're not normally talking about is how many manufacturing jobs are actually open. And by the way, the Bureau of Labor Statistics projects 68,000 auto mechanics openings each year through 2033. You know, I covered this in a video a few weeks ago. I'll post a link to it here. I've got a buddy of mine who is the regional manager for a bunch of auto mechanic shops, and they're using AI to supplement a lot of what they do. But what AI is not doing is getting their hands into vehicles and making adjustments and changes. These jobs are not going away anytime soon. You could put in the comments below if you think that they are. I think that those jobs are going to become different, but they're not going away. And speaking of different, let's go a little bit deeper into that. What the Ford CEO Farley says is that we do not have enough trade schools. We are not investing in educating the next generation. Sure, you could go to a four-year college degree, but as we've seen time and time again, those kids are not finding jobs. The college graduate unemployment rate is out of control. It's out of control. We covered this just last week. I posted a link to it here. Young people cannot find jobs. That's because they're not getting the right skills. You're not learning the right stuff. You're learning what worked over the past 10 to 20 years. You're not learning what's gonna work over the next 10 to 20 years. And that's, I think, something that we need to really, really look at internally. And if you disagree with me, put it in the comments below. If you agree with me, put it in the comments below. Guys, that's where the magic is happening. Let's look at this trade school though. So the Ford CEO says we don't have enough trade schools. Well, there's currently 7,500 trade schools in America. There's 1.5 million students enrolled in these trade schools with another 2.5 million in vocational education outside the traditional schooling system. He says, if we talk about additive manufacturing, robotics, automation, and EV batteries, we'll see very few focused curriculums that can keep up with that. Well, what's he saying? He's basically saying the same thing I just said. We're teaching people what worked in the past. We're not teaching people what's gonna happen in the future. Manufacturing, robotics, automation, electric vehicle batteries, automation. You know, one of the things we're gonna talk about this right now, because there's a bigger problem that's looming and we're not educating people enough on, and that's data centers. I know when I talk about data centers, I don't get the views that I do with some other topics, but we got to talk about data centers for just a moment, because there's a huge, huge, disastrous problem that's looming with data centers. Right now, the U.S. lacks an incredible workforce to manage all these data centers. Why are these data centers important? Well, they run everything, guys. If you were to lose internet, anything that you don't have access to is being run in some way, in shape and form, off cloud computing and on these data centers. And as AI and digital electronics becomes more and more ubiquitous, we're gonna need more and more data centers. The data centers have to happen. They have to happen. But, I mean, according to my research, we're about 600,000 manufacturing jobs away from that, and 500,000 construction workers away from the data centers and EV plants that are necessary to push these initiatives forward. And by the way, this could potentially slow AI growth, which is projected to reach $4.8 trillion by 2033. So what are we saying here? Guys, we have all these ambitious projects that are necessary to push the AI, robotic, battery revolution forward, manufacturing revolution forward, but we don't have enough people to serve those jobs. Sure, we're getting people with political science degrees or social studies degrees or lesbian dance theory degrees. Shout out to all my lesbian dance theory majors out there. Good luck. But regardless, what we don't have is, hey, how do we put together the next generation of batteries? How do we manage the robotics and automation that is going to be necessary to build out the next wave of robotics? By the way, you might have noticed I just had a lower back spasm. I was on a vacation with my wife last weekend. I don't know, I pulled something, either biking or paddleboarding or swimming, I don't know. Anyway, stick with me, boys, I'm still here. This is how committed I am to the channel, to have a fresh video out 6 days a week, even with lower back spasms, a few Excedrin, I'm out here and knocking. Okay, so anyway, we don't have enough jobs for the auto dealers. We don't have nearly even close to enough jobs for all these data centers. And you know, one of the problems there though, and we talked about this at length, people don't really want these data center jobs. They don't want them, because here's the problem. It's very temporary. You know, maybe for 2-3 years, you're going hard. There's thousands of people working on these data centers. But once the data center is done, you don't need thousands of people working it. You need dozens. And the robots are going to come, and they're going to man and serve a bunch of their roles too. So, you know, I think there's a problem. Now, my stance would be, if you understand what you're doing at the data centers, and you're smart and you're thinking and you're understanding, you're going to be able to continue to like pivot and upskill. Okay, I learned, you know, you go to an employer and say, yeah, I spent 3 years at this data center and this is what we did. This is what I'm excited about in the next generation. Cause it's not like the data center upgrades and updates are not going to continue. The technology is only going to get better. And the more knowledgeable you are about the previous generation and the more well-read and listened you are on the next generation, I think you're going to be good. If my kid, or kids, if either one of them were really interested in this topic, I'd say double down, triple down, understand how these data centers work. Because they're not going anywhere. Combine that with the ability to lead people and you've got something there. So anyway, we've got these data centers, maybe over 1 million jobs necessary to do the build outs that are needed. But the problem is people don't want the jobs, as we mentioned. And you know, people don't want these in their backyard either. You know, just this is shocking. Google had to pull out of a huge plan. They were at like the last leg of a nearly 500 acre build out in Indianapolis. But in September, they had to pull out. The people didn't want it there. Microsoft, 244 acre build out in Wisconsin earlier this year, had to pull out of it. So what the next problem that you have is that, you know, these companies that are investing all this money, trying to get people trained up, trying to get the hardware, trying to get the CapEx funding, we'll get there in just a moment, are having to pull out of these projects at the last minute. So you've got a bunch of interesting problems happening in the data center and new technology world. And this is exacerbated, guys, by the fact that all these tech companies are what are propping up the US economy right now. You look at what's happening on the stock market, and we've talked about this in the past, the Magnificent Seven, these big tech companies, are propping up everything. So we could potentially have some dominoes going where there's not enough people to build out these data centers, there's too much pushback from the public, there's not enough energy, there's not enough cooling. All these problems can kind of stack on top of each other, and we could be on the cusp of a disastrous market economy if these data centers aren't built, because OpenAI, NVIDIA, CoreWeave, Microsoft, they're all just paying, they're all just pouring money into each other to build out these projects. And if enough of these projects fail, if enough training doesn't happen, there's big problems. So anyway, I appreciate you guys watching the video, and let me know in the comments, what would you say if you know, if your kid, if your friend, someone you knew was like, you know what, I'm gonna go to trade school and I'm gonna learn about the next generation of batteries. I'm gonna learn about robotics and manufacturing. What would you say to that? Would you say, I think you need to go get a four-year degree at a local university? How would you feel? Would you feel like you needed to push back on that idea, or would you say, hey, trade schools are legit? I wanna hear from you. Put in the comments. If you enjoyed today's video, smash the like. I've got a couple really good videos coming up this week that you're gonna like, so subscribe and let me know in the comments below, what do you think about these trade schools? Put in the comments below, do you think the data centers are a good thing, they're a bad thing? How do you think the trade skills roll into it? Let me know your comments below. I would love to hear from you. And if you enjoyed today's video, you will be very interested in what happened yesterday, where we covered Vercel, big AI company, firing 90% of their sales staff. Why? AI and automation. You got to figure out exactly what they did, why they're doing it right here. I'll see you there, boys. See ya. Peace.